forget to check his list twice when he was putting your gifts under the tree. Do you have gifts that are maybe too big, too small, don't work, or just aren't you? It's time to brave those return lines, people, and here to help us navigate them more successfully, it's our coupon crazy mommy, Natalie Reed. Natalie, good to see you.
Hi, you too.
It's a crazy time of year, right?
I know. Okay. We survived.
What are the most returned gifts?
Well, 14% of electronics are returned, 16% of toys and games, mm-hmm. and 62% of people did not like the sweater that grandma picked out for them.
That Christmas sweater. We're seeing a chart there breaking it down percentage-wise. All right, so what are some of the key things to remember when we're making those returns?
So most stores are lenient when you're trying to return after the holidays, but a lot of them now require you to have some type of identification, like a driver's license, because sadly people are returning stolen items with fake receipts. So make sure you have an ID with you and your receipt. If you want a full refund, you're going to need your receipt.
I know, but sometimes we don't have the receipt. So what do we do if we don't have it?
So if you lost that receipt, which I know I do, I shove things in purses, and they somehow disappear. It does. If you have the credit card that you purchased with, sometimes they can look it up by that. If you don't have a driver's license or a receipt, you might just end up with a store
credit.
Sometimes
you end up having to swap it for something else in that store.
Yes.
All right. It's a crazy time of year to be returning things, though. So my question is, a lot of people want to know, is this really the best time, directly after Christmas, really the best time to make those returns?
I say if you can wait till maybe the first week of January, you're going to avoid all the crowds, and with that comes slow customer service, plus you're going to avoid all those after Christmas sales where you're going to be tempted to spend more money. So I would say wait if you can.
Yeah, absolutely wait if you can. It'll save drive time.
Right.
All right. I love this because you always make things so easy for us. You break things down in easy to understand lists. So I want to talk about the companies on the nice list, you know, all those companies that make it so much easier for us to return those unwanted items.
Sure, absolutely. I love Kohl's because they have a return policy. Return any item, anytime, for any reason with a receipt.
Really?
But if you don't have the receipt, you can still get a full exchange or a store credit.
Okay, that's good to know.
Nordstrom's is next. They are well known for their great customer service. If you make an online purchase, you always get free shipping, plus you get free shipping on your returns
all the time. Shipping is huge. Free shipping is huge. Okay, who's next?
Costco. Okay. You don't need a receipt because your purchase is tied to your membership card.
So they can look you up.
Right, exactly. Okay. Plus, you have a 90-day return window on electronics, which is better than most competitors. Okay. And then if you make an online purchase, they'll refund you all the shipping, even return shipping.
Nice.
I know. Very nice.
Okay, who else do you have on the list?
So Target is actually now on my nice list. They used to be on naughty list.
Listen, I'm telling you, they weren't always the easiest when it came to
returning. They were sticklers.
Things.
If you did not have a receipt, it allowed you 2 returns per year worth only $35.
Remember that?
Yes.
Yeah.
So now you can return up to $70 per year without a receipt. But after that, you can exchange for the item in the same department based on the current price.
That's a huge improvement.
Yes. Plus, if you make an online purchase at Target, they're going to pay for return shipping. And if you're a Target Red Card holder, which you should because you always get 5% off, plus you're going to get 30 extra days to make your returns. Have you ever shopped Zappos?
Of course.
Discount shoe retailer. This is so cool. They take returns up to 1 year after purchase. Plus, they'll pay for return shipping.
I know.
Awesome. Love that. And then Walmart, I love. Walmart makes it really easy to return.
They do.
And then this is what's great for the holidays. So items that normally have a return exchange period that are limited, if you make a purchase between November 1st and December 24th, that return period actually will begin December 26th.
Okay.
So that includes items like TVs and cameras and DVD players that usually have just that short 15 to 30 day window.
All right. You also say Amazon is on your nice list. Let's get to the naughty list, though.
The
really
naughty
quickly.
List.
We don't have much time left.
Sears, no refund without a receipt.
Okay.
And then if you do have a receipt, the return policy is kind of hard to understand. It's this tiered system with certain items falling in certain categories with different return windows.
All right. Who else?
Best Buy, the time frame for your return depends on whether or not you've joined the My Best Buy Rewards program and how much you've spent over the last year. They raise you to an elite or an elite plus status and gives you more or less days to return.
So, and all of these stores are going to be on your website.
On my website.
Okay, so for complete wrap-up of all of her great tips and a list of those nice and naughty stores, all you need to do is go to Natalie's website. It's couponcrazymommy.com.